Hey, folks. Chris Garlock here with Michael Redmond, 9-down professional. Game 51 in the AlphaGo versus the World Series. Thanks so much for joining us. Michael, this is a very interesting game. We have a new player, and he's got a different strategy we have not seen before, right?
Yes, it's Chou Chun-hsun from Taiwan. Hmm. And he was the leading Taiwanese player for a while. And in 2007, he won the LG Cup. So he's also a world champion. There was a period when he was playing in the Chinese leagues, I think. I'm not sure if he's still doing it, but so he was playing in the city leagues in a Chinese professional team. A very prominent player. And in this game, he's actually going to try mirror go, mane go, copying his opponent.
I wonder when somebody would try that.
Yeah, it's an interesting strategy. You can see he's played the center point, and he's playing the same moves as white after that. And this is a strategy that has been actually experimented with in the past. And I sort of wish he had done it with white. So that's probably just the draw. So it was, and I wouldn't be surprised if maybe he came to this game with the idea that he was going to test this. Mm-hmm. Because basically it's a test of the computer system. Probably not so interesting for the player himself because he's just copying the opponent. Sure. But it is a meaningful test, I think, for the computer system to see what it's going to do with copycat Go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, absolutely. I can't wait to see what happens, actually. I'm not...
I do want to talk about a game played back in 1929. Between Kitani Minoru and Go Seigen. Mm-hmm. We've talked about these two players before, and they were very good friends. They were rivals, and they did a lot of experimentation together. In 1929, this was before what they called the New Fuseki or the Shin Fuseki. Mm. And so that was the opening where they were experimenting with the Tengen, the center point, or high openings and stuff like that. So they were doing that a few years after this. But in 1929, Kitani did experiment with the idea that black could play the center point and copy white. And at the time, they did not have any komi. And so there was a very thorough study of this that Go Seigen and Kitani did after the game. They concluded that black could keep a three-point lead, usually. Even if white played in a way that to nullify most of the value of the Tengen point, then there would usually be about three points left. Mm. And I think this game has sufficed to prove that, you might say, or to reinforce our knowledge there, to agree with that conclusion that Go Seigen and Kitani came up with. So it did work that way. But if the human had white and played Manego, it would have been different because I don't think I wouldn't be surprised if AlphaGo does not have a plan for that. Hmm. And actually, to tell you the truth, I think copycat Go with white works to a certain extent against the modern programs like Lila Zero and Katago. Like it doesn't really mean anything because we're using these programs to research the game. Mm. We don't really learn anything by beating them or having a chance to beat them,
of course,
by copying their moves. But it is interesting that they don't, and because when white plays Manego, the human plan is usually to set up ladders. And if you have ladders coming towards each other from diagonal points on the board, then the player playing the first move is going to capture the one ladder while the other ladder for white is going to fail. So that's the typical way that we use to defeat copycat Go when white is doing it. Of course, that's not going to work for white here because black has the center point. But when white does it, we use this special strategy to stop white. The strategy that Lila can use is Lila Zero can try to make the center point important and then finally stop the copycat Go by playing the center point at some point. And so it has to play a game where there's a big moyo and then play and make it an important point. It doesn't really do that very well. It's not part of its system, I don't think.
Interesting. Wow.
And it makes sense that computer programs will have this problem. You're going to see this go on for a while. So let's just jump forward a bit. You can see he's copying all the moves. At this point, this is move 70.
Wow.
And Black has played exactly the same moves as White. So you might think that maybe it's close to even, but the answer is no.
Wow.
The answer is no, because Black is winning by just 2.5 points, according to Karago. Karago says that Black is winning by 2.5 points before Komi. So Black cannot pay the 7.5 point Komi.
Interesting.
Actually, in this series, I think it's six and a half. So Black's winning percentage is down to 32%. It's already pretty bad.
Wait. So Black, so he copied all of White's moves, but he's losing.
He's losing. Like it's a proof of the fact that playing the center point and then copying your opponent is not a good strategy, because obviously none of these moves that Black played are mistakes, because they're the same as AlphaGo. They got to be pretty good moves, right?
Yeah.
But
it's
just the overall effect is that the center point is not worth very much. Right. And so this sort of agrees with the conclusion that Gosegan and Kitani came up with, that whatever happens, this center stone is probably going to be worth about 3 points. I think it agrees with that.
Interesting.
Because Karago was giving an average of 2.5 points, it could be a 3 point difference before Komi. So the proper move for Black was to play like this and just answer, after which like B and C are sort of interchangeable points. So like White could play here, White could play here, or White could leave them both and play here to stop Black from doing something like White just did on the right side. It's going to be close before Komi. And so there's no way Black's going to be able to pay the Komi in this game.
Wow.
Instead, he could copy White. He could continue to copy White, and he would just lose by about 3 points anyway. So he plays pushes, and this is going to get very bad. The moment he stops copying White, it falls apart. So like this. This was a very sharp move that AlphaGo played. Actually, it was probably better for Black to cover here, in which case White will play like this. It's just no good for Black, but this would have been closer in the game. This was a very sharp attack that White had here. White cuts off the corner. Black needs one more move in the corner to be alive. And so White gets to push through and cut here. You can see White got a lot of profit on the side there. And Black is left with a group that is not very safe. For instance, Black probably has to protect here, and White will continue with something like this. And White is looking to play at the key point at A next. It's like Black is on the defensive here after White has scooped out the right side territory. So White got both the territory and has some potential to attack in the center. So it's just good for White. In the game, Black jumped in here.
Ooh, wow.
I think in this game, I want to go to the end. I'll just show you the moves from here.
Okay, sure, yeah.
It just gets worse and worse. Black, it's not as if Black made any mistakes. It's just the fact that he started out with a difficult position and was trying to do something with it. It's not working. And at this point, White is live on the right. White is live on the lower side. White doesn't even have to do anything to connect those two groups. So White plays away.
Oh, wow.
And so White has, while most of the board positions are equal, they're identical positions, you can see White got a big chunk here that's extra, and White is keeping this side territory. So there's these two areas in which both areas White is gaining something, and the trade-off is this area here, which is relatively small. So Black got a bit upset, I suppose, maybe played when he played here.
I was just wondering,
and this is just going to finish off the game, because at this point he had to resign.
Oh dear.
If Black takes here, if Black takes the one stone, White can just squeeze here, and Black's going to lose those stones on the lower side.
Oh, dear.
So it's the end of the story here.
Oh, my goodness. Crash and burn.
Mm-hmm. So it was an interesting idea.
Yeah.
I did a copy. And I think that if we assume that Joe came to this game with the idea that he would try this out, It would have been more interesting if he had happened to have the white stones. And that was probably just the luck of the draw. So he was out of luck there. And I think that I would have been interested to see, like, because these people at Google, the people at DeepMind, they did, although they open sourced the whole system, I do think they tweaked with it a little bit when they actually made AlphaGo. And they could have been doing some things to get rid of problems that they saw as bugs, you might say. And things that they would be worried about happening in a match like the match that they played against Lee Sedol, or the later match that they played against KJ. They would be worried about things like this happening. And so there is a possibility that they did something about that. And I would have liked to see it tested.
Yeah.
It would have been a lot. It would have been interesting to see this happen with the human player playing as white instead of black.
And I don't think we ever, I mean, we only have what?
No one ever tried it. It's just that it is sort of, it's not so exciting for the human player to be copying the moves. And I don't think he, I think he was just trying to prove something, to figure it out.
Yeah, and
just test the machine, because it's a worthy idea.
Absolutely.
It would have, in this case, it just served to confirm the result that we already had when Kitani and Gosegan had studied it almost 100 years ago.
Very cool.
But if it had been with white, maybe we would have gotten a different answer.
Well, as always, Michael, bringing not only your great analysis of the game, but also some perspective and some Go history. So thanks for that. And thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed our little foray into Mirror Go here. It's interesting. And we will see you next time. Thanks again.